A big hello to everyone. This is this week's episode of The Witching Hour. And I know that today I was supposed to show you the experience of me having my hair changed, and I was supposed to talk to you about how I maintain my hair when it is purple or when it's turquoise or any other color of the rainbow. But I've decided to postpone that until next week because I have something that I think is much, much more important that I need to talk about. So for those of you who follow me on Facebook, I made a post a couple days ago about how I was thinking about making a documentary. So how this all was sparked was that I was actually getting anonymous hate on my ask.fm. Someone had told me that I had said something wrong and I was in the wrong by how I identify versus who I'm dating. So what the comment was, they had asked me, as a lesbian, would I date someone who is trans? Or why do lesbians not date trans people? And I said that, in my opinion, the reason that I wouldn't is because I want to date someone who identify to their female anatomy. So what I meant by that is that I want someone who loves their vagina, who wants their vagina, and no matter what their gender may be, that they do love their anatomy and want to keep their anatomy and identify to it. So the reason that I wouldn't date someone who is trans is because, for myself, when someone tells me that they are trans, so let's say female to male, then I automatically say they are men. To me, they are a man. And I identify as a lesbian who dates women, queer women, genderqueer women of all sorts. So the comment that I had received, someone twisted the words that I said, and they said that I had said I would only date someone who was female, and that made no sense because I was clearly dating someone who was trans. So firstly, they twisted my words, and that's not what I said. But secondly, they gender policed my partner and said that my partner was trans. So to touch base briefly on that, Kai is not trans. Kai is non-binary. So I went on to my Instagram, onto my Tumblr, and I explained that I didn't think it was right that someone was telling my partner and telling me what my partner identifies as. So this whole scenario sparked an interest in me. I wanted to create a documentary because it seemed to me that the LGBT community, we don't actually know that much about each other. Or how much do we know about each other? So I thought it would be really interesting to explore exactly what do we know about each other, about lesbian, gay, bisexual, transgender, transsexual, pansexual, asexual, and everything under the rainbow. And not just that, but it seemed clear to me that this comment was coming from someone who was either part of the LGBT community or who was around the LGBT community. So my next question that I wanted to explore was, when did LGBT pride, this big umbrella that we're all supposed to love each other under, when did it turn into a place where we hate each other for who we are and where people don't feel the freedom to be who they are and everyone is gender policing one another and saying, this is your sexuality, this is your sexuality. So I sat down with a director today, and he's very, very interested in the project. So what we're doing right now is that he's looking into funding, we're looking into how exactly can we make this happen. And what I would like to do in the meantime is that I would like to formally invite anyone and everyone who wants to be a part of this project to do so. And that is not limited to Montreal. Like, you can live anywhere in the world, and we will try and do our best to make this happen. So we are looking for people who are in the LGBT community, pansexual, asexual, bisexual, gay, transgender, no matter what. You can even be a straight ally. You can be someone who's heterosexual, who is gender queer, who doesn't fit into the gender binary system. Anyone and everyone who wants to be a part of this project, we would love to have you a part of this. So you can send me your name, you can send me information on AskFM, you can send it to me on my Facebook, on my Instagram, on my Tumblr. You can reach me through here, you can reach me anywhere that you want. If you have a story to tell, if you have something that you think the world needs to hear and that other people can find hope in and that they can relate to, then we absolutely want you to get in contact with us. This is going to be, I think, a very, very big project. And as I said, it is not limited to just people who are gay or lesbian. This is to our heterosexual allies. These are to all gender queers and everyone under the umbrella. So please send us a message, pass this on. Pretty soon we're actually going to be making a FundMe account. So we're going to try to get everyone to help us out, get as much funding as we can, so we can go to all these different places in the world, and that we can visit you, and that we can hear your story, and that we can put it into this documentary, this beautiful, amazing documentary, and that we can share it with the world so that they can be more educated as to who our community is, so that we can be more educated as to who our community is, and that we can also learn to love one another and why we should love one another. So that is my message for this week. Next week I will be making a video on hair maintenance, something a little bit more lighter of subject, but I really wanted to get this message across, and I hope to be hearing from absolutely everyone.